Back in 1997, with the global success of his blockbuster feature film Titanic, James Cameron delivered the history of the legendary tragedy to the public as never before.
Titanic is enormous. That's why they call it Titanic. Well, I think what happens is that Titanic sort of is like a black hole. It sucks you in.
To understand the impact of the ocean liner's disappearance, we must return to her origins when Titanic was already a world wonder. The construction of the Titanic begins in 1909 in Belfast, Ireland, and takes over 3 years to complete. Measuring 269 meters long and 53 meters high to the top of the smokestacks, Titanic weighed in at 46,000 tons and cost $7.5 million, or the equivalent of $201 million today. She was widely thought to be unsinkable.
The Titanic represented in 1912 as the top of the top, and it was the best ship ever built and the biggest one ever built.
At the time of Titanic's disappearance, no one on Earth knew how or where she could be found. But explorers continued to seek ways to probe the deep unknown, limited only by the technology of the day. And it was in fact early filmmakers who drove the evolution of this science as they began a quest to film under the sea. In 1916, only 4 years after Titanic's tragedy, the telescopic contraption is used with an underwater camera by the Williamson brothers on the set of their feature film, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. The operator did not descend below 20 meters underwater, but film audiences were blown away as nothing comparable to date had ever been witnessed. For one of Titanic's key explorers, each precious artifact should be considered in its own right.
The key that sent the SOS, to me, that's a historical object. And I like the idea of having things that persist through time, that are carefully curated, that 500 years from now, people can still look at that key and remember that story of those two young guys that typed that SOS. So they became heroes of the story.